bless the Lord. I do give God glory because this is a special time for me. I just want to say that it's so good to speak, and it's important to obey the voice of God when he speaks to us. Next month, October the 7th, 2016, will be 1 year that I'm being obedient to God and operating in my call from God and the passion that God has placed in me, which is prayer. I'm sharing this month because it really began in September when I felt a strong tug and a strong urge from God to not just pray just for the general area, but to pray for the world. I didn't have any idea what to do about it, who to talk to, or where to start or anything. But over the years, I have realized and I've operated in obedience to God's voice and just walking by faith and not by sight. And I know that when we go forth and we did go forth and do what God tells us to do, that he would do the rest. So I began to speak with Reverend Ray, and I began to share with him the passion that I had for prayer. I knew that he had the When Christians Speak Talk radio. So I shared my passion with him and my deep desire to pray for others. So Reverend Ray began to, you know, talk to me and share with me about the freeconferencecall.com, et cetera, and to make a long story short, I received a phone call from Reverend Way, and he had already set up the freeconferencecall.com under When Christians Speak Talk Radio. Reverend Pat Randall had already done the flyer, and on October the 7th of last year, Midday Glory was launched. And I give God the glory because I'm so excited when I know that I'm doing things for God. So it's just a blessing. It's been a blessing to me. It's been a blessing to sit before God and hear from God for the people of God. Amen. So we're going to go forth next month and talk about more of the one-year anniversary. But for the meantime, I thank God that he's always ahead of me, and he's already given me the topics that we're going to be doing for this month. So today we're going to be speaking about passion for seeking and knowing God. And then the following weeks, we're going to be talking about intimacy with God, the power of God, and then we're going to be talking about keys to a powerful prayer and effective prayer life. Amen? So glory to God, to his name. So today, briefly, we're going to speak about passion for seeking and knowing God. And looking in the Old and the New Testament, the word seek means to seek the face of God, to diligently search for God, to wish, to crave, to investigate, to pursue. Only God can really touch our hearts and give us that desire to seek and to know him and to want his will and plans and ways above our own ways, because sometimes we can get in the way. Jeremiah 24:7 says, "And I will give them a heart to know me, that I am the Lord, and they shall be my people, and I shall be their God." Chronicles 29:18 says, "O Lord God of Abraham, Isaac, and of Israel, keep this desire in the hearts of your people forever, and keep their hearts loyal to you, and prepare their hearts unto you." Glory to God. It says, "For it is good; it is God that worketh in us both to will and to do his good pleasure." Intimacy with God and the fullest possible fellowship and partnership with him comes as we desire and as we seek to know him and his plans and his will and his ways, not our ways. Praying and spending time with God is all about desire. It's all about passion for God. It is not a religious discipline in our Christian walk. In Exodus 33:13 says, now therefore I pray thee, if I have found grace in thy sight, show me now thy way, that I may know thee, that I may find grace in thy heart." In other words, if God is pleased with us, we'll continue to ask God to teach us his ways, so that we may know and that we can continue to find, that he can continue to find favor with us. Glory to God. And in Psalms 27:4, David says, "One thing have I desired of the Lord, that will I seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, and behold the beauty of the Lord, and to inquire in his temple." David went on to say in Proverbs 42, "As a deer or as a hart panteth after the water, brooks, so pens my soul after thee, O God. My soul thirsted for God, for the living God." Glory to God. The Lord desires that we seek him, that our souls thirst for him, that our bodies long for him. By the Holy Spirit, it quenches our thirst, and we will be blessed with the living water from on high. Glory to God. All we have to do is that we have already experienced his power. We've experienced his glory. We experience his love that is better than life, glory to God. We must devote our hearts and our souls to seek the Lord with our heart. We must taste and see that he is good. We must bless him at all times. And we must continue to praise him regardless of what's going on in our lives. We must magnify him, exhort him, and trust him. We start with little faith. Then it increases to strong faith. But the ultimate goal is for us to have great faith in Christ Jesus. Glory to God. Prayer is a great privilege for a sinner to come into the very presence of the Almighty God, the Almighty Holy God, and communicate and fellowship with him. Prayer is a ministry that we are all to participate in. Prayer is doing God's work. We can never be too busy to pray. If we have so much business and we don't have time to pray, we have to realize that that business did not come from God. Amen? We must be careful with our time because our time belongs to God. Everything that we have belongs to God. He's earned it because he sacrificed his life that we might live. That's why we need to seek him with our whole heart. God's word shows that prayer touches God's heart, and he will respond and work in our lives. We call him and intercede for others. Amen? So let us pray. Glory to God. Almighty God, early in the morning, O God, do we seek you, Lord God. In the midday, Almighty God, do we seek you. In the evening, O Lord God, we seek you. Glory to your name, Lord God. We know, Almighty God, that you love us, God. We come together on this midday hour, O Lord God, to give you all the glory and to give you all the praise. We thank you, O Lord God, for your word. We thank you, O Lord God, so much for your guidance, O God. We thank you so much, Almighty God, for your instructions, O God. Oh, God, if it was not for you, God, where would we be today, Lord God? We love you, Almighty God, with an everlasting love, oh, God. We know your love never ceases, oh, God. We love, oh, God, your love, oh, Lord God, towards us is greater, oh, God, than yesterday, Lord God, and it will be greater than the day after, Lord God. We know, Almighty God, that you can rest in, that we, oh, God, can rest in you, Lord God. We're casting out all of our fears. We're casting out all our anxiety, oh God, all our concerns to you, Lord God, for you are our provider, oh God, you are our way maker, Lord God, you, Almighty God, are our God, all power, oh Lord God, is in your hand, God, we get excited, oh Lord God, just to realize just who you are, God, you are the great I am, you are, oh Lord God, the bright and the morning star, oh God, you are the King of kings, you are the ruler of the universe, oh God, there is nobody like you, oh God, you have opened doors, oh God, that others have shut in our face, God. You have given us strength, oh God, to climb any mountain, oh God. You have given us strength, oh Lord God, to trust in you with our whole heart, oh God. You have given us strength, oh God, just to rest in you, Lord God, just to seek your face, glory to God, hallelujah. Oh Lord God, we thank you, oh God, for all that you have already done, God. And you, Father God, will continue to do for us, Lord God. There is no one, Almighty God, that can take your place, oh God. You are the all-powerful God. You are the God, Almighty God, that is more than enough, oh God. You are our banner. You are our peacemaker, Lord God. You are our high tower, oh God. You are our protector. You are our shield, Lord God. Oh God, when we think on your goodness, God, we humble ourselves in the sight of you, Lord God. Oh, God, with all that we have done, God, all the sin that we have willingly committed, that we purposely committed, God, you have the power only, oh, God, you have the power to look beyond our faults, oh, God, and to see our needs, oh, God. You have the power, oh, Lord, God, to forgive us and to forget our sins, oh, God. And you have the power, Almighty God, to cleanse us from all unrighteousness, oh, God. All we have to do, God, is to confess. All we have to do is to seek your face, God. All we have to do, oh, God, is desire to give you glory, oh, God. Oh, Lord God, we praise you today, Lord God. We glorify you, God. We extol you, God, because you are worthy. You are worthy, 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 oh, glory to God. Almighty God, we cry out for the nation today, Lord God. We humble our hearts, oh, Lord God, so that you may be able to use us, God. We ask, oh, God, for cleansing daily, oh, God. For Father God, we want, Father God, to be right in your eyesight, God. We want to be cleansed from all unrighteousness in the name of Jesus, God. We desire, Almighty God, to be washed whiter than snow in the name of Jesus, God. We desire, Almighty God, to be used by you, God. We desire, oh, Lord God, Father God, that our prayers are answered, oh, God, in the name of Jesus, God. We pray, Almighty God, today, Father God, for the young babies, the infant baby, Father God, that are born, Father God, with drugs, Father God, withdraw because their parents, oh God, or their mother, oh God, were doing drugs while they were pregnant, Lord God. We pray, oh God, for the babies that we hear on the news, oh God, that have been tossed in dumpsters and in trash cans, left for dead, God. We thank you today, Lord God, for those babies, God. We thank you and we pray today, oh Lord God, that they will not be affected, oh God, with, Father God, what they have gone through in their young lives, in the mighty name of Jesus, God. We plead the blood of Jesus, God. We pray, Father God, for the drug addicts today, Lord God, that they may have a desire to be set free, Lord God, that they may have a desire, Almighty God, to know you, oh God, in the pardon of their sins, God. We pray, God, that they will have people surrounding them, oh Lord God, to lead them, oh Lord, to the path of righteousness in the mighty name of Jesus, God. Today, mighty God, we want to pray, God, Father God, for those that are in poverty, Lord God, for those who don't know, Almighty God, where the next meal is coming from, God, for those who don't know, God, where their rent or their mortgage is coming from, God, for those, oh God, that may be on the edge of being tossed out of their covering, Father God, the living quarters, Lord God. We pray, Father God, for churches. We pray, Father God, for different ministries, oh God, to come and to help those people out in the name of Jesus, God. So many, oh Lord God, are destroyed. So many, oh God, are going through so much, Lord God. We pray, Almighty God, today, Father God, for the stages of dementia, Lord God, for those, Father God, that suffer in Alzheimer's, Lord God. We pray for those, oh God, who are, Father God, for the diseases that have caused blindness in their bodies, God. Diseases, oh God, have caused lameness in their bodies, oh God, and they can't even see, they can't even walk, Lord God. We pray, Almighty God, for that person, oh God, who has been diagnosed today, God, with an incurable disease, oh God. We pray, Almighty God, that their faith is strong in you, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, God. We pray, Almighty God, for the person, oh God, that is in the operating room right now, Lord God, and the doctors are saying that it's no good news, Lord God, but we pray, God, that their faith is stronger than you, glory to God. We pray, Father God, for every known and unknown disease, Father God, that you nailed to the cross over 2,000 years ago, God. We pray, Almighty God, hallelujah, Father God, for the blood, God, that you suffered and you died, Lord God. Father God, that you took every disease to the cross, God. We pray right now for deliverance, Father God, from everyone, Father God, that the doctors have said, God, that has an uncurable disease in the name of Jesus, God. We pray, Almighty God, for those, oh God, who have suicidal thoughts, God, those who are depressed, God, those that are lonely, those that feel unloved, oh God. We denounce the curse right now from Satan in the mighty name of Jesus, God, and that spirit does not belong to the child of God. So, Father God, we thank you right now that spirit is moving out of the way by the power of God. We speak power of God, and we speak the authority of God in the lives, Father God, of those people in the name of Jesus, God. We pray today, Almighty God, for those that are in the hospitals, God, those, oh God, who are in rehabilitation facilities, Lord God, those, oh Lord, in nursing homes, and those, oh Lord God, that is in hospice today, Lord God. We pray, Almighty God, Father God, that these people will seek you, Lord God, and that they will know you, God, that they will seek your face, God, and that they will turn, Father God, 100% to you, Lord God, not dwelling on, Father God, their condition, God, but dwelling on the mighty God that we serve, God. We pray today, God, for an anointing like never before of our ears to hear your voice, oh God. Oh, God, today, God, with all that we hear on the news, we continue to pray for the safety of our children, Lord God. Our children, oh, God, that are in daycare, our children in pre-K, God. Our children, oh, God, that are in kindergarten, in the mighty name of Jesus, God. We pray for the children, oh Lord God, that are in elementary and high school. We even pray today, God, for the children, oh, God, that are in college, oh, God. And we thank you in advance for their safety, Lord God. We thank you in advance for academic excellence, Almighty God, in the name of Jesus, God. We pray, oh, Lord God, for the safety, oh, Lord God, for our children, oh God, as they ride the school bus, as they walk to school, Lord God. Even some of the high schoolers, oh God, as they drive to school, God. We bind the spirit of accidents in the mighty name of Jesus, God. We pray, oh Lord God, for compassionate teachers, oh God, and all the workers, oh God, that deal with the children, oh God, in the name of Jesus, God. We pray today, God, for compassionate bus drivers who will, Father God, have compassion on the children in Jesus' name, oh God. We pray, oh Lord God, that they will arrive home safely, Lord God, that no parent, oh God, will have to be concerned about their child, oh God, not being dropped off at the right bus stop, their child not, Father God, being arriving home and safe in the right time in the name of Jesus, God. We pray, Almighty God, for safety, oh God, for all children, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus, all over this world, God. And we bless your name for, God. We pray today, oh Lord God, for families who have, Father God, loved ones, oh God, that are gone on, Lord God. Loved ones, oh God, that may be going through a separation right now, Lord God, through transitioning, oh God, into death, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, God. We pray, Father God, for families, oh God, that are going through, Father God, illnesses, Father God, with loved ones, God. They're going through car crashes and all different types of issues, oh God, that they're going through, God. We ask, oh God, that they would just rest in you, Lord God, that they would just trust you in the mighty name of Jesus, God. We pray, oh Lord God, for families who love ones, They'd be in hospice today, Lord God, and the doctors are giving them up. The doctors are saying, God, that there's nothing else that they can do, Lord God. Oh, Father God, we know, dear Lord God, that Father God in Ecclesiastes said that there's a time and a place for everything, Lord God. So, God, we thank you today, God, that you will prepare our hearts, oh, God, for the different things that we must go through in the name of Jesus, God. Oh, God, we pray out today, God. We cry out today, God, for church leaders, oh, God, not just the pastors, God, but everyone in the position of leadership all over this world today, Lord God. We pray, Almighty God, that we will have a passion for you, Lord God, that we will seek you, Almighty God, with our whole heart, that we will, Almighty God, be doers of your word, Lord God, that we will keep your commandments in the name of Jesus, God, that we will strive each and every day for righteousness, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, God, with our whole heart, Lord God, that we will confess our sins so that we may be able, oh God, to continue, oh Lord God, to be pleasing in your sight, God. We see the world and all that's going on in it, Lord God. We see the adultery, Lord God. We see the fornication, Lord God. We see the hatred. We see the envy, Lord God. We see the strife, Almighty God. We see the jealousy, Lord God. We see the same-sex marriage, Lord God. We see the world, my God, doing the opposite, oh God, of all that you have created, Father God, for us, Lord God. Oh, God, we desire to be like you, Lord God, and not like the world in the name of Jesus, God. We desire, Almighty God, to seek you early in the wee hours of the morning, Lord God, that you may hear, that we may be able to hear your voice, God, when everything else is still, Lord God. And, Father God, it's just you and I, Lord God. It's just all of us, oh, God, just, Father God, hearing, Father God, what you, Father God, would instruct us to do for the day, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, that as we wake up in the wee hours of the morning, God, we can feel the very presence of you, Lord God. We will know, oh, Lord God, that you are present with us, God. We will know that your anointing and your power, oh, God, is with us in the name of Jesus, God. And God, as we begin to close this prayer today, God, we decree and declare that your glory, oh God, will shine in us, your power, your peace, God, your anointing, oh Lord God, will be revealed in us in the mighty name of Jesus, God. We desire, oh Lord God, that you will use our mouth, oh God, that you would use our mouthpiece to glorify your name, God, that we will be witnesses, oh God, to a dying world today, Lord God, that we will go out, God, and we will help the elderly, Lord God. We will help those who cannot help themselves, God. We desire, oh Lord God, to be led, Father God, by you to be able to help others in the name of Jesus. We desire for others to see you in us, to see your glory in us, God, to see your power in us, oh God, in the name of Jesus, God. We give you all glory. We give you all power, God. We rest in you, Lord God. We trust in you, Lord God. Our faith, Almighty God, is great in you, Lord God. There is no one else, oh God, that we can serve, God. There's no one else, Almighty God, that can do us the way you do, Lord God. Father God, we thank you, Lord God, and this is your servant's prayer today. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray, and our hearts and our soul says amen, and thank you, Jesus.
Amen and amen, amen, amen. Again, everyone, we pray that you have a blessed rest of the day, afternoon. Know that God loves you, and don't forget we do have a broadcast tonight with Pastor Paul Morgan. He will be on tonight at 7 o'clock at Blog Talk Radio. Reverend Gwen, thank you again for a prayer. Welcome again, everyone. We're starting a new time. Our time starts at 1 o'clock. It's 1 o'clock to 1:20. Reverend Gwen, thank you again, and everyone else that's on the line. God bless you. God bless you, and God bless you.
Amen.